Friends, so today I would like to take this a very very famous question which has been asked in so many MBA entrance exams and campus recruitment tests. I'm sure you can relate to it, and then we will see on what mathematical famous concept, unbelievably, it is based on. So the question is, there is a 12 liter jar which is fully filled. There are two jars of 8 liter and 5 liter capacity, but they are empty. They do not have anything in them as of now. So you have to put this 12 liter in these jars, whichever way you want to do. The only thing is, at the end of the operations, I should get 6 liter in the first jar and 6 liter in the second jar. So the question is 660, this stage I should get in some time after minimum steps or whatever. So how to go about it? So I will tell you the modus operandi. I am sure you can relate to it, and then we will discuss on what concept it is based on. You have all the opportunity to pause the video and do it on your own. Okay. So first step, what we do is we put this entire 12 liter jar in the 8 liter jar. So it will become 4, 8 and 0. This is the condition after first step. Now what we do is we put this 8 liter in this third jar, 5 liter. So it will become 4 as it is. This is 3 and this is 5. This is third, second step. Now what we do, we put this 5 liter again in the first jar. So it becomes 9, 3 and 0. This is step number 3. Now we put this 3 in the third. This 3 liter in the second jar, we put here. We just emptied there. So it becomes 9, this is 0, this is 3. Then we put this 9 over here. That is a basic idea of doing all these things. So when we put over here, we get 1 here. The whole idea is to somehow get 1. And we get 8 here, as it is capacity 8, and this is 3 as it is. Then we put this 8 over here. So we get 1 here, and now when we put over here, already 3 liter is there, the capacity is 5, so it will take 2 more, so it becomes 5. And since 2 liter has gone, it will become 6. And then the final step, we put this 5 liter in the first jar, we get 6, 6 and 0, which is our idea, which is our objective. So after just 6-7 steps, we have been able to get 6, 6 and 0. Now I'll tell you what, the idea is we can get any kind of combination in this. If there is 8 and 5, we can get any kind of combination. Why? I will very shortly tell you. So first look at a question, similar question. What if this was 32 liter, for example, this is 20 liter, this is 12 liter, this is capacity, and this is completely filled. So 32 liter jar is completely filled, this is 20 liter capacity, this is 12 liter capacity. After doing any number of operations, I want finally this should have 18 liter, this should have 10 liter, and it should have 4 liter. This is my objective. How do we do this? So again, if you pour this into this, it becomes, let's say if we try, so this becomes 12, this becomes 20, and this becomes 0. So if I pour this into this, for example, so this is 12, this is what? 8, this is 12. Now if you watch very carefully, this number is 20, 8, 12, you know, 12. These numbers are always multiple of 4. That is the entire idea of this question, which is an unbelievable application of nothing but the concept of highest common factor, HCF. The HCF of these numbers is 4, 12 and 20, the HCF is 4. So whatever I will be doing over here, whatever, from here to here or here to here, in other words, I will always be able to create all the multiples of 4 and nothing else. So in other words, I will never be able to get 18 here. So this condition is impossible to get. Please understand. However hard you try, you can never get multiples of 2 which are not multiples of 4. You can never get 4k plus 2 kind of numbers. The answer, the numbers that will keep coming will always be the multiples of the highest common factor. That is the concept of this very famous a series of questions which have been coming. So coming back to our original question, if you recall the values of the containers were 8 and 5. The HCF of 8 and 5 is 1, highest common factor. So that means we can get all kind of scenarios because the HCF is 1, highest common factor is 1. And therefore by doing some kind of shuffling here and there, by applying logic to get 1 somehow, we can create the numbers. Thank you very much.